Good morning, everybody. It's the next day. Last night I recorded somewhat of the door panels, from what I can remember. So like I said, I already put them on. They look really good. They're like 2-inch tweeters, I'd say. I mean, there's my thumb. They're pretty big, actually, for tweeters. And then I got the other one in. They look pretty good. That one I scuffed the bottom and the top left part of it a little bit, but it's not too bad. They look pretty clean. Yeah, there's the evidence of me cutting it, but yeah, they look pretty good. So I'll get back to you guys. Well, it's going to be morning for me, but for you it's going to be like a second. So I'll get back to you guys in tomorrow. Like, I'm going to be posting this tomorrow if I make the video tomorrow, but it's going to be longer for me. You guys are going to be like this. It's freezing as balls outside. Have the back window wiper going. All the windows are frozen up. Like, the front window's all freaking. And, like, look. There's, like, snowy ice there. I was gonna put the new JDM sticker I got in the mail, finally, from ordering, like, 2 weeks ago on. I got two of these. One for the hatch, one for this guy. It's, like, an 8-inch one. Pretty sick. I gotta get the rest of the stuff done. I pretty much already got them in. The tweeters are already in. But I had to put a hole inside the part where there's the pocket for the door inside, because that's where the crossovers are going to go, because there's not really anywhere to put them behind the door panel in this car unless you put them inside the door. But I don't want that because it's going to be rattling against the metal and this is stupid. So if they're in here, it'd be nicer. Plus, I can get to them and they're accessible when I need to, you know, hook them up or whatever. And then I got the two crossovers that are gonna go in there, you know, one's for each woofer, well, mid woofer and tweeter. So we're gonna hook this up in the car in the Accord. I'm gonna go outside and start wiring this crap and getting it together and putting the panels on, and I really can't wait to hear how this component setup sounds, because I'm only gonna run it off of the Pioneer touchscreen head unit, double DIN one. I can go look up and see what the wattage is on that, but hopefully they sound pretty good. So I'll get back to you guys when I get to the car.
I'm a young dreadhead with anxiety, and I love it when a bitch can try me. I don't trust nobody, cause I can't be fake. Finding ain't an option, cause my soul can't change. Stay young, bitch, that might pull up to your beard. Reel it in, I got the bag.
Guys, long story short, I got the front door speakers in, I got the tweeters in, it sounds freaking awesome, but due to the fact that I'm recording with my phone and playing music at the same time, can't hear it because, well, I can't play any music on there because it won't go through, it won't play at the same time. Look, if I try to play it, the video will just stop. Or not. No sub in it yet. But something I did not know about this car, well, there's rarely any of these cars out there. Oh yeah, we got a JDM sticker on there now. Christmas, bro. Even Christmas is already gone. There is a 6x9 subwoofer type of deal going on back here. Who knew? The Yukon, the 2002 Yukon that I sold, had the same deal going for it, but it was like a 10-inch or 8-inch sub. I wonder if that works. I'm gonna go grab a 6x9 that I got in here and hook it up, and maybe it'll play. That'd be pretty sick. Actually, I'd probably leave that hooked up and then put the subwoofer too, because that's just pretty sweet.
What's that noise?
I don't know. All right, I just unscrewed this. Let's see if we can pull it out here. Yep, we can. What is this? Yo, look at that. It's so dusty. Dust is literally... There's freaking two of them? What in the heck? This is some real JDM stuff that only people that have had this know and worked on this. Because this is crazy. I didn't even think they would have had something like this. There's like a coil on it too. There's two coils on it. Man, this is really hard to get out. Come on, buddy. Let me set the camera down. I gotta do this with one hand. There we go. All right. I got it out. This is some actual 6x9 stock. Like a subwoofer type of deal. Had a little bit of space in it too. Look at this, guys. That's so cool. Look at that 20 watt 6x9. 1991 Honda Accord USA 4 ohms. That is so cool. That's really cool. But here's the deal. There is two outputs on this. You know what? Is that an amp? Oh no, that's the motor for the antenna. That's really cool that it has that. But which do I use here? Are they the same? Because that thing had two on it, so I was acting like a subwoofer with the two hookups on the back, but I'm not sure how to, I wonder if that was acting just as a bigger speaker with more thump. I really don't know how that works, but I wanna see if I can make this fit in here, because if I can, that'd be pretty sweet. Let me go figure out some wiring. So, okay, so basically, I got those two 6x9s in that box. Here, let me just, you can see them. Basically, they did work. So it turns out that that subwoofer type of 6x9 back there, that's so JDM cool thing. You know, that's something that you rarely see, and I'm sure that was like one of the top of the model, top line of the things for like options for this car, because I'm sure it's a very rare thing, especially since these cars are already so rare. That's probably a really rare option to get with it brand new, and it's just kind of cool to have it. And you know, it's not something I'm gonna have to JDMize or whatever. But yeah, it's really, really cool. So I got the tweeters and the doors in and the mids, and then you can see the crossovers I have in there. I drilled a little hole in between the door so I could fit everything, the wires through, and then have the crossovers in here. So if I ever want to hook an amp to them, I just have to run the wire through there, and it's really close and easy to just hook it up from there and not have to rewire a bunch of stuff. Same with this side, you know. So we're gonna go over to my local park and do a distance test, etc. I'm actually really happy with these speakers overall. They're very loud for what they are, and they sound very crisp and clear when you have them set right, of course. You don't want to just throw them in there with a bunch of bass. These are not really bass speakers at all, I'll be honest. I haven't used MDF rings for the doors for when I put them in. I didn't like cover any of the big holes or anything, but I just need mids for right now, and you know, highs. But it sounds really good. I'm really happy with it. You know, I can go cruise around, listen to music, and not have an issue with it going anyway. And then the back, I think that's gonna have a little bass, since that those wires were back there for that little extra 6x9 bass. I think that's gonna have bass, to be honest with you. I might have to hook an amp to them, but you know what, I'm just gonna use the 10 anyway. But I'll probably have those because I'm assuming they still produce normal mid sound with the tweeters, since they're coaxial 6x9s. So let's go try them out. I think they might move a little air too. I mean, if it subwoofer was really hooked up like that, well, the 6x9 woofer anyway, it might sound okay. And I'll add the 10 anyway, just because I have it. But I'm gonna leave those back there for sound. Also, there is speakers in the roof of this car. Can you see those right there? And then one right there. One is blown completely, and the other one sounds okay, but it's not the best. And the front door speakers were completely garbage in here, and you saw the 6x9 in the back there, and that was completely garbage too. But I'm gonna go close the garage and put my tools away, and I'm gonna take off and go try it at the local park for a distance test. My normal spot was taken up by somebody sleeping in their car, and I wasn't gonna disturb them and wake them up. So I'm home now. I'm gonna open up the doors. I can't hear much now. My ears are it's pretty loud. It's not super loud, like you need ear protection, but my ears definitely feel like I hear less right now. I'm gonna open the doors and open the trunk and just let it go for like a couple, maybe 30 seconds. I'm in my, you know, where I live, so I don't wanna piss people off too much, but it's not, like the subwoofer's not loud, it's the talking that's loud, but it's so quiet, this is gonna be bad. All right, let's do it. Alright, I gotta play it for like a couple seconds and turn it off. I don't want to piss my neighbors off.
They hear me, can't see me, they hate.
I think the entire park just heard the word nigga. Like my video, please. before I get kicked out of my house and then I have to become a YouTuber to pay my bills. Like the video, subscribe, and I'm gonna get kicked out of my house now.
Sometimes I feel like I gotta.
World, yo. Cause all the pressure is.